Power BI July 23 update. GA4 is now available. You can connect to data in Power BI with the GA4 connector. Universal Analytics went away on July 1, 2023. Now, marketers and people with access to GA4 websites have been using GA4 for a little bit over a year, but they have not been able to have a connector in Power BI to directly connect to that data. Also in July, 33 new dimensions were brought into Google Analytics. And so in this video, we're going to show you how to connect your Google Analytics 4 via the Demo 2.0 connector, Google Analytics, and then we're going to give you a refresher on metrics and dimensions so you can see what kind of data you can bring into Power BI. It's probably one of the more powerful and most used connectors for marketing people trying to get data into Power BI with the GA4 from Google Analytics. We're going to show you how to do that. Let's go to Power BI. Back in Power BI, the July 2023 update to Power BI does include an updated beta connector to GA4. Now, for those of you who do not know and do not work in Google Analytics 4 a lot, the Universal Analytics, which has been the go-to Google Analytics source for the last 7, 8, 9, 10 years, that expired on July 1, 2023. So everybody is now required to be using GA4. So a lot of marketing teams and website teams updated to Google Analytics 4. And as of before July 2023, you could not get data from GA4 into Power BI. They had a connector for the Universal Analytics. But in July 2023, they added the GA4 connector. We're going to show you how to connect to that. First off, in Power BI, I have a brand new file. The only thing I have in here is a date query, and I'm just going to use that for demo purposes, but we're going to show you how to get data. If you have never connected to a data connector source in Power BI, it is under Get Data. That will bring up multiple sources to connect to. And we are going to choose the More option. The More option will bring up a list of online sources, and there's literally over 100 sources of data you can connect to, and they are usually adding additional data sources. And if you scroll down, you will see a connector for Google Analytics. And when you connect to select Google Analytics and connect to it, that will bring up the implementation 2.0. And that is the beta format, but it is working as of July of 2023. So when you select the 2.0 beta, now remember, you must have access to Google Analytics. If you do not have access to a Google Analytics account and are not signed in, it's going to ask you to sign in to Google Analytics. Now, I'm already signed into my Google Analytics account. So the first thing it's going to do once you connect to Google Analytics through that beta 2.0 is that all of your Google Analytics accounts are going to come up. Now, I have access to a website that I've named Demo Account Web, and then I also have access to the Google Analytics demo account, but you do not, they have withdrawn access to connect to Power BI. So we're going to use a demo account that has all of the different dimensions and the metrics. Now, there's two types of data inside Google Analytics 4. There's what we have as metrics, which has this little bar symbol, red, gold, and blue, and they have all the different dimensions and metrics listed all the way through. You can scroll down. You have the different dimensions, which is this symbol, and then you have the metrics, which are the red, gold, and blue. So we're going to choose a couple of metrics, which are basically numbers. The numbers in Google, so sessions is going to be a number. That is a metric. So we're going to choose sessions, and total users. And this is the total number of sessions in the data time that it has been connecting to GA4 and the total users. And then we're going to select a dimension, and the dimension we're going to check is the date. And now you see the date, the sessions, and the total users. Now again, when you load data into Power BI, you usually want to transform that data so that way you can make any data changes before you actually load it into Power BI. So we're going to transform that data, and that is going to bring up the Power Query screen. If you've never seen this, this is your basic Power Query screen. You can start to transform your data. You can start to add columns. We recently did a video on 25 data transformations in Power Query if you want to watch that. Now, the first thing you're going to notice is you're always going to want to name your query. So we're going to name this GA4 Web Data. So you're going to want to name your query, and then your applied steps so far are the source of that query, which is the GA4 account. And then all we've done now is added the items. The next thing we're going to do is check the data types. The date is a date data type. The sessions is a whole number, and the total users is a whole number. So that is all we're going to do to add that data to GA4. Now, the only thing we got to do now is actually load that data into GA4. So we're going to close and apply. And close and apply is going to be the load function for Power Query. If you've used it in Excel, it works very similar in Power BI. And again, I recommend some of the different Power Query videos I have available to watch to kind of get to know Power Query. But if you just want to load data, and you can add as many sources of data from all of the different metrics and also the dimensions from GA4. So we're going to hit close and apply, and it's going to load that data and apply those changes. It'll load that data into the query, and then it'll bring it up into your Power BI, and it's going to load into the report view, because that is currently the report view is what we're in. Now remember, the report view is where you're going to make your visualizations. Then you have the data view. And if I go to the GA4, we now have the date, the sessions, and the total users. Now just to show you how this works, we can start to build out your different measures that you want to make, and we're going to be doing a video on making a Google Analytics 4 dashboard, but currently we're just going to show you how to load that data into Power BI. So we're going to make one change. We're going to change this to a short date. That will be the short date for the GA4 data. And now we can start to build out our measures. We can go back to the report view. We are going to click on the GA4 web data, which is, and make a measure. That measure we're going to make is going to be called total users. So this is DAX. Again, if you're not familiar with DAX, maybe you're just trying to connect to the data and somebody else on your team is going to make the measures, but we are going to use total users, which equals the sum, and we are going to use the GA4 total users, and then we're going to close out that parenthesis. And then if we build the visual, we now have a total users measure, which is the calculator icon. And if we select the card visual and bring the total users into that visual, we now see the number of total users. And the next measure is going to be total sessions. So total sessions is going to equal the sum, and we're going to choose the sessions column. We're going to write parentheses to close that. and we're going to click on a blank area of the screen. We're also going to bring in our total sessions. So then we could start to use a date table to start to build out a dashboard. But as of right now, since GA4 data has been connected for this website, we have a total of 2,218 total users and a total of 2,181 total sessions. So that is how to connect data from GA4 into Power BI. Remember, you have your dimensions and you also have your metrics. And your dimensions and your metrics will then import once you load that into Power BI. That is a look how to connect GA4 data by using the Get Data feature inside Power BI to connect to Google Analytics 4 using the beta connector. Remember, you do have to have access to GA4 and you do have to be signed in. When you go to the GA4 connector, it'll ask you to sign in if you have not signed in to GA4. That is a look at how to connect to Power BI to GA4 data, the July 2023 update, part of the updates to Power BI.